Before we begin this episode of 1700, Sin and RMI TV acknowledges and pays respect to the traditional owners of the land on which the media collective and studios stand, the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nations.
Sin and RMI TV also acknowledges and pays respect to the elders and traditional owners of the land our content reaches.
Hello and a very warm welcome to another episode of 1700 Home, the show where we have an extensive and exciting look into the Australian music scene
and bring you news, music clips and everything to discuss within this vibrant industry. I'm your host, Vic.
And I'm your host, Nick. Now, look, as you can see, we are still recording from our own homes as the stage 4 lockdown restrictions have been implemented. But that won't stop us from bringing you another jam-packed episode of 1700 Home today.
That's right, Nick. We'll be discussing the latest music news, revealing our clip of the week, and sharing our ultimate Aussie releases for 2020. So don't go anywhere.
Look, Vic, I know we've said this before, but I think we can say again, this is the same episode of 1700 Home like we've never seen before. What do you think?
For sure. Let's do it. It's time for your 1700 news with Vic and Nick. Now, this first piece of news might take you back to a time before you were even born, but is definitely a significant part of Australia's music history. Molly Meldrum and Gavin Wood, or should I say the former host of the show Countdown, will be reuniting for a new podcast called Gavin Wood's Countdown. This podcast will reflect on the impact of Countdown, as well as featuring guests that were on the show back in the day. If you have not heard of Countdown before, it was an Australian music television show that ran from 1974 to 1987. Some of the artists we know and love, such as Madonna, ABBA, Blondie, and plenty more, have gained success in Australia due to this show. So I'm truly excited to listen to this podcast. I think it's a really cool way to, you know, involve the new generation with a really big part of Australia's music history that I think we all should respect and understand the amazing impact of Countdown. What do you reckon, Nick?
This is so exciting, Vic. Look, as you said, Countdown was such a successful program in highlighting music artists from all over the world and was also really prominent in bolstering the music scene here in Australia. I think this notion of revisiting and reintroducing Countdown is so beneficial and will definitely bring about those nostalgic sentiments. Keeping with this excitement, the Yours and Ours Festival have just announced an all-ages event for next year and the lineup for the occasion, including the likes of Hockey Dad, The Vans, and Jerome Ferrar. The new event is to take place in late January in the New South Wales city of Wollongong. And this is obviously in addition to the 2021 Yours and Ours Festival, which was postponed from this year. And let me just say, includes a stellar lineup. So, so great.
And next, our local tracks handpicked from our friends at Sin's flagship show, Sunday Suites, are the following.
So starting with our feature album, we have Hooper Crescent with Object Permanence. Then going on to our hit feature tracks, starting with Eye Jail with Chitty, Perfect Moment with Lost in Rome, Stumps with Mount Pleasant, Two People with Someone to Serve, and Vic's got a few more coming up now.
We've got Big Words with Sink or Swim, Cool Sounds of Alive, Hike Your Hands with Fashion Model Art featuring Sophie Tucker, and Obscura Hole with Duma. So if you want to listen to these tracks, get the ultimate insight on them. Remember to check out Sunday Suites on every Sunday from 5 to 7 p.m. on 90.7 FM, or just look it up on the Sin website. So guys, we know that you've been watching Nick and I on your screens for a couple months now, and we thought it might be a good time to get to know us a bit better and what type of music we like to listen to. So today we've decided to pick our ultimate three releases for 2020. So I'm going to start, but Nick, what do you think of this idea? Is it time to get them to know us a bit better?
Vic, I absolutely love this idea. When you suggested it to me, I got so excited. I think there's been a lot of standout songs this year, and from both the international and Australian music scenes. So I'm really excited to hear your picks. Go right for it.
All right, so before I start, I think I need to explain my taste, but I'm a big hip hop fan. I do enjoy listening to pop and a bit of house or electronic, but you're definitely going to see a hip hop influence in my tracks. So number one is TK Maisel featuring Carrie Fo, which is Don't Call Again. This is a new release. It only came out a couple of weeks ago. And if you haven't heard of TK before, she's a Zimbabwean born Australian hip hop artist and rapper. I personally find this track so groovy, but it showcases her vocals so beautifully. I mean, every time I listen to it, I always sing along. I love the sound of this one. Okay, number two. Number two is Arno Faragi and To Another with Just a Phase. So this song is the product of Perth-based and Zimbabwean-born rapper Arno Faragi collaborating with Sydney production duo To Another. The beat in this track is super chill. It kind of reminds me of a West Coast Kendrick Lamar type of sound, and I'm all for it. It has the perfect balance between hip hop and electronic, and let's be honest, that's always a good combination. Number three is Don't Need You by Genesis Owusu, who is just an artist that can do no wrong, honestly. He's an Ghanaian Australian artist that always delivers funky and distinctive beats. This song is no exception. Again, another song you can easily sing along to that gets you in those really feel-good vibes. You know, I love this track. I love all these tracks. So I hope you like my ultimate tracks for 2020. Nick, what are your picks?
Well, look, first of all, Vic, they were some absolute standout bops. So great selection there. It's going to be hard to top that. But look, I think the hardest bit about this is I've always had a bit of an appreciation for all kinds of music, from pop to folk, disco to soul. So it's been really hard to pick a few. And I've also grown an intense appreciation for the Australian music scene. So in light of all that, the three I've picked today are number one, Thelma Plum with Clumsy Love. Now, Thelma Plum is an incredible artist within the Australian music scene, and she has some really powerful lyrics and timeless melodies. This song has become one of her most famous, and I'm sure it will remain that way for many, many years. Number two, we have Sending Me Your Loving by the Jungle Giants. Now, this was actually a clip of the week earlier this year, so it's pretty exciting. I remember when we announced this on our live show, and this song exhibits some really cool beats and rhythms, and a tune that will endlessly provide the opportunity to have a dance, and I think that's all what we love to do. Finally, I'm going Last Night by Ricky Lee. Now, look, Ricky Lee has undoubtedly become one of Australia's most beloved artists since appearing on Australian Idol a few years ago, and it's not hard to see why. This is her most recent song and was released earlier this year. And again, like Sending Me Your Loving, like Thelma Plum's Clumsy Love, this song just provides the opportunity to zone out, have a dance, and really just be filled with positive vibes. And that's exactly what Ricky Lee was after with this song. So a really great task that was, Vic. It was so difficult because there were so many songs we could choose, but I think those are the three ultimate tracks for this year.
Nick, I feel like you picked some of Australia's best talent as well. You have a good range. And yeah, I remember when Send Me Your Loving was our clip of the week, and it's a great track as well. All of them are. So guys, I hope you've enjoyed getting to know us a bit better and what type of music we listen to. We want to know if you like this or if you have any suggestions for us based on what we've selected today.
Absolutely. Get in touch with us. We're on Instagram, we're on Facebook, we're on YouTube. We are all over the social accounts. And let us know your ultimate track. I think it's a really tricky task, as we were saying, but it's always good to see what other people are listening to and what is your top songs for 2020. So get in touch and have a dance.
Now, it is time to look at our clip of the week.
This week's clip of the week is, drumroll, Big Heart by No Frills Twins. Ooh, I don't know
what I like. Maybe you'd be my type. With focus on both finding yourself and self-acceptance, Big Heart has quickly become a powerful and timeless anthem.
Look, once again, this is a standout bop from No Frills Twins. Make sure to check it out on streaming platforms and add it to your top hits playlist. Unfortunately, we have come to the end of another episode of 1700 Home with your hosts, Vic and Nick.
Remember, if you want more Aussie music-related content, we are on Instagram at 1700_TV and YouTube 1700TV.
You can also catch the team doing 1700 Pulse, artist interviews, and of course, our clip show on Channel 31 each Wednesday and Friday night at 5 p.m.
Regardless of our circumstances, we do really thank you for continuously supporting our show and allowing us to share our love for the local music scene with you.
So for now, stay safe, everyone. This is Vic and Nick signing out.